Okay, so let's get started. So today our topic is unit 4 in e-commerce, that is electronic data interchange. In short, we can call EDI. So today in this session, we are going to learn about three topics. So first one is what is an EDI, and second one is the process of an EDI, and next the main components of an EDI. So in the examination, they may ask a question like this: what is an EDI, and explain the process and the main components of EDI. So for this, we need to write about these following PPTs. So first, let us go for what is an EDI. See here. First of all, we should write a point that is what we need to elaborate the abbreviation, that is EDI stands for electronic data interchange. So in that electronic data interchange, we see three words. What is electronic, second one is data, and the third one is interchange. So already know what is the meaning of interchange. So interchange means what? Exchanging something. So here what we are exchanging means what? Data. So data means what? Right? So the data can be exchanged in the form of what? Some documents. We can prepare the data in the form of documents called MS Word documents, Excel documents, or PowerPoint documents, or any other kind of Excel documents, or any other kind of documents. And these documents we can exchange. But what type of documents we can exchange, where we can exchange, who can exchange, so how we can exchange, what are the procedures we need to follow. So that I will discuss in our future PPTs. So here we can exchange what data, so in the form of what electronic media. So that's why whatever the documents we are exchanging through electronic or through internet or through any network, so that is called what EDI, nothing but electronic data interchange. And here, see right side, you are able to see one picture here, right? So this is what EDI or EDI system, and here it is showing what one is what your company, and the second one is what trading partners. So these are the two different systems or two different business partners. So we can say two different companies. And here, let's see. So from this company, we are transferring what the document, EDI document, to this trading partner. And from this trading partner, they are transferring what EDI document to this company. That means what? In between two different computers or two different companies or two different business partners. So using this EDI system, we can transfer what documents. So that too in the form of what electronic media. So that's why this is called what EDI, in simple way we can say. But how we can transfer, where we can transfer, who will transfer. So what are the things we need to follow, that we'll discuss in our future PPTs. And the second point is what EDI is the computer to computer exchange of business documents. So between the companies in standard data format using networks such as WAN, and sort of wide area network, that we will discuss in our later sessions, what is WAN and what is the use of WAN, or by using what are the any public net internet. See here it is showing what a computer to computer exchange of business documents. So business documents means what? The documents are which the businesses, two businesses or two companies or two business partners or some trading companies, and any kind of companies, whenever they are doing the business, so they need to collect the document, they need to prepare the documents, they need to transfer the documents between the companies. So those documents will be transmitted or will be shared with electronic media. So that's why those business documents which are transmitting to internet, so those are called EDI, electronic data interchange documents. So and next third point, so the EDI documents can be invoices, any kind of invoices whenever we take purchase orders, when we are giving order for any product online, that is called purchase order, and any transaction bills, whenever we are paying any bills, any online bills, or any insurance claims, or any health insurance claims, or any life insurance claims, any type of claim documents, or inventory documents which are showing some stock, right? Inward stock or outward stock, and any payment confirmations. So whenever you are paying something, so So you need to get what payment confirmations online. So those are also comes under what EDI documents. So all these type of documents should be transmitted over the internet. So with the help of this EDI system, okay. And next, what are the use of the main EDI means? It replaces the paper based exchange of business documents. Suppose if there is no kind of the internet or any network or any electronic media to transmit the documents, we need to go for what manual exchange. If it is manual exchange means for, so every company or every person, every business or every trading partner has to prepare the documents manually, and they need to take the printouts, and after taking the printout, that must be posted or that must be sent by post manually by putting in some covers, envelope covers, and that must be mailed to other companies. That takes a lot of time, at some days. And at the other end also, they need to collect that post documents, and they need to same thing should be entered in their systems. So for that they need some human power, manpower, and they need some time, and they need some paperwork, they need some time. So all these some drawbacks in the manual exchange of documents. So how we can eliminate all these drawbacks means what? With the EDI system. So without any human intervention, so any companies can transfer these documents through online. So that is the main advantage of this EDI system. And how these EDI documents will be transferred means what? The EDI system will use what in standard format. What are the documents the company prepared? The documents will be converted into standard format, and that standard format EDI documents will be transmitted over the internet to other business partner. And next point is what EDI documents can flow directly out of a sender's computer. That means what, this, for example, this is a sender computer and this is a receiver computer. And from this sender computer, the documents will be transferred directly to this receiver, and from the receiver to sender. So without any human intervention, that is the use of what EDI. Okay. So this is about what EDI, the only the meaning, this meaning we can write, right? These points we can write as a meaning of EDI. And next we can go for what next slide. See here. So without EDI, how the documents will be sent, how the orders will be processed, and with EDI, how the orders will be processed. See, so if you see the above the diagram, this is what order processing without EDI. So they are not using what EDI system. So they are going for what manual process only. See here buyer, and here also buyer, in the middle what supplier. Here buyer is what generating the purchase order in the computer. So after generating the purchase order in the computer by using any MS Word or any Excel sheet or any using any application, and after preparing the document, he is going to print the document, same document on the printer, and they are posting sending the document by putting that document in the cover, envelope cover, and the same thing is sending to the supplier. And supply is what receiving this order, which is prepared by receiver. And the supplier is what same thing is what recording or feeding in this in their system manually. And after sending, saving the document in their system, that invoice, he will generate what invoice based upon this receiving order, supply order. And the same thing will be printed on their printer, and that invoice will be they are keeping on what in envelope cover, and the same thing is posting to this buyer receiver. That means what here the documents are what preparing manually, invoice and purchase orders are creating manually, and they are taking printout, and the printed paper is sending through what a post mailbox. And this means for this take what they are using what lot of paperwork, and they are spending what a lot of time, and they are wasting their work, and they are putting their efforts, and by sending and receiving all these documents, they need to take what some days, right, 2 or 3 days, or sometimes 7 days. So this is having what some drawbacks. So these drawbacks will be eliminated with the help of what by using what EDA. So below this diagram is what processing their orders with EDA. So here same buyer and same supplier, and see here. Here purchase order is what recording in this computer, and without taking any printout and without sending that manually, he is sending what that order with the help of what EDA. That means what they will use what some communication media or network, and through that communication network, the in the other end the supplier will what can receive this purchase order, and based upon this purchase order, the supplier will generates what invoice. That same invoice will be transmitted to the buyer system without any involvement of any human. Automatically, whatever the software they are using at the buyer system and supplier system, that will prepare the orders and that will generate the invoice and that will be transmit those documents automatically without any human intervention. So this is about what EDA, what the main use of what EDA system. And if you go for next slide, so we need to talk about what is EDA process, what it involves actually. So in this EDA process, it involves what three major steps to send any EDA documents. So who will send these EDA documents means what the companies or any businesses or any business partners. And this process involves what three steps here. So one is what preparing the documents by the company, and after preparing the documents, so those documents must be translated or converted into some EDA standard format. And how these documents will be converted into EDA format, that we will discuss in the next sessions, right? So after translating EDA documents, those documents must be transmitted to the business partner, to the receiver, by using some transmission media. So that's why this EDA process involves only three steps. One is preparing the documents manually. So these documents can be prepared with the help of what any MS Word or any Excel or any kind of application nowadays we are using, right? And after preparing the documents with the help of our normal applications called Word, Excel, PowerPoint, or any kind of applications which we are using in the computer, and those documents are not, we can't say those documents are standard documents. So that's why before sending those documents to other person, other business partners, the documents must be translated into some standard format. So those documents are called EDA standard documents. And after converting or translating those EDA documents, so those documents must be transmitted to other partner by using any communication media. And what is that communication media we can use, that I will explain. Okay, so only three points, three steps are involved in this one. And next, see here, next slide. See here, this process we can explain with this diagram. See here, I'm taking two examples, two company examples. One is sending company and second one is what receiving company. And see here, the sending company is preparing what their documents, preparing the document. This is the first step in the EDA process. So they are preparing their documents by using what any kind of application software called Word, Excel, PowerPoint, or Excel, or any kind of applications. Or we can say, we can use what this ERP packages or accounting package software, any software or application we can use to prepare the documents. That means what documents, you know, what type of documents we can prepare means what? We can prepare any invoices, any purchase orders, any inventory documents, or any payment documents. Okay? So those documents can be prepared in the systems by the company by using what their own application software. But whatever the documents they've prepared, those documents we can't say the standard documents. So that's why we should convert those documents which are prepared by the company by using their applications. So with the help of one software called EDI translator, see this one. After preparing the document, those documents will be sent to this EDI translator. This is a software which is maintained by both the sending company as well as receiving company. And what this EDI translator or the EDI software does means, so it will translate the documents into EDI format. So this is what after converting, translating, we'll get what EDI data or EDI documents. And these are called standard documents. And how they can make the documents into standard format means by using some kind of EDI standards. So what are EDI standards which the companies can use to convert the documents into EDI documents? So that I will discuss in next topic, right? So after converting EDI documents into EDI documents by using any communication software, so that software may be what any direct point-to-point communication, any direct link between the two companies, also by using any public network or any other internet service provider, that is called EDI network service provider. And most probably they will use what a WAN network, wide area network. And what is WAN network, what is the use of WAN network, how it works, so that I will explain the our future. And see, by using any communication software, that is direct or point-to-point communication or else any EDI network, the documents will be seen. The documents, this EDI software will be connected to that EDI network service. And after connecting, the EDI documents will be transmitted to other business partner, right? So at the other business partner, they also can use what EDI translator if they want to send any documents to sending company, right? So vice versa, this process is what of a vice versa process, right? So this is about what the EDI process, which we can explain with the help of this diagram. And if you go for a next one slide, that is what the components of a EDI system. So we can say components are also called what elements. So what are the three main components or elements which we are required to send any EDI documents or to receive any EDI documents means? So the first one is what EDI standards, and the second one is EDI translation software, and the third one is EDI communication network. That means what this EDI standards means, what these are the standards or protocols, communication protocols, or any EDI software which is used to convert the documents into EDI standards. And EDI translation software is what it will convert the documents into EDI documents by using these EDI standards. And after converting the documents into EDI documents by using these EDI standards, so those EDI documents will be transmitted to other company with the help of some communication network, that is called EDI communication network. And this is also called WAN network, right? So that I will explain what is WAN. And next, if you go for next slide, that is what a first component of EDI system, that is what EDI standards. So what are EDI standards means, which provides standards for your documents. That means what every organization which they want to transfer any kind of documents to their business partners, so they must agree on the specific EDI standard, and they must use some specific EDI standard version. That means what, that is a software, EDI software, simply we can say EDI software. And that software provides a standard for your document. So this is a standard used for what? Exchanging EDI document. And next point is what? The EDI standard defines the data structure and the content for the business transactions transmitted between the computer applications. So your computer applications means what? The applications which are maintained in the computers of the companies. For example, sender company will maintain their own computers. In their own computers, they will maintain their own application softwares. And by using their own application softwares called Word, Excel, or any other kind of application, they will generate their own documents. And those documents must be what? Transmitted or convert into EDI standard or EDI format. So for that document, the standard data structure and the standard format or standard content will be created or will be defined or will be provided by these EDA standards. Okay. So for example, if you talk about EDA standards nowadays, which we are using most popular, that is what one is what ANSI EDI. So ANSI stands for American National Standard Institute. And this standard is what given by what one ANSI organization, American National ANSI organization. And this will develops what standards for different documents. And simply we can call, this is also called what ASC X12 standard. And the second one also we can use, some other companies are using what EDIFACT, EDIFACT. So EDI stands for what electronic document interchange for administration and commerce and transport. So this is another standard nowadays which the companies are using for getting standards for their business documents. So we can use any one of these standard, right? And next, if you go for next slide, so that is what the next component of EDI is what EDI translation software. So once your document got standards for using that EDI standard software, so this EDI translation software C will convert your data into some EDI format. Okay? So in order to convert these documents into EDI standard documents, that software will use what some standards. Those standards will maybe what ANSI X12 software or else EDIFACT software. And this translation software, see the name itself tells what is EDI translation software. This software will translate the documents into EDI. The major functions of EDI software are what? Data conversion and data formatting. So whatever the data you created, whatever the documents you created, those documents will be get converted. And after converting, it will provide what some formatting, standard formatting. And how the documents will be converted into standard documents, that I will show you with the example after this class. At the end of this PPT, I will show you the real-time example, how one manually prepared document will get converted into some standard documents. So next point, it consists of what computer instructions that translate the information from unstructured format to the structured EDI format. So unstructured format is whatever the documents we created. So all those we can say unstructured formats only. And these documents will be get converted into structured format with the help of the EDI software. And next, the third point, the implementation of EDI software involves mapping between different document types. So your mapping between different document types means what? Some companies will create the documents by using MS Word. Some companies will create the documents by using Excel. Some other companies will create the documents by using accounting package like Tally, LynxFocus. And some other companies will create the documents by using what ERP package. That means what they are using what creating different type of documents. But these different type of documents will be mapped or integrated with the help of single software called EDI software. And after mapping all these different type of documents, so it will connect to the business partners who are involved in the exchange of documents. So they're called business partners. So they may get connected with the help of this EDI software. And it provides what integration to other business applications, what they are using, such as accounting package or ERP software or any other kind of software. That means what? Simply we can say, whatever the documents are created by using what different applications by different companies, all the companies, all the applications of different application software, all the documents created will be get integrated under this EDI software. And this EDI software will translate those documents into some standard format. Why? Because some company will create what document with MS Word, and some company will create the documents with Excel. So all those type of different type of documents will be converted into a single standard format, and that formatted document will be transmitted to different business partners. So these are the three main components. The second component of EDI, and next one, if you go to third component, that is what communication network. So we have EDI standard. The company is maintaining what EDI standard or EDI software, and by using that EDI standard or software, the company is what transmitting or converting their unstructured documents into EDI standard documents, and after that, after converting the documents into EDI documents, how they will exchange EDI documents to other business partners. So that will be done with the help of our communication network. So communication network means what? The network which provides communication between the parties, or between the systems, or between the applications to exchange something. So here, this communication network will provide the communication between the different organizations with the help of what a third party service provider, that is also called what a VAN, value added network, right? So what this communication network does means, so this EDI network is a secured communication network. So what is secured communication network means that already we discussed about what is communication network, what are the different security mechanisms we need to discuss to provide security for our data, which is transmitting over a untrusted network called public internet. So already we discussed in the second unit. Okay. So that's why these are communication network also provide what secured communication network between the business partners to exchange their EDI documents. And one of the most important communication network nowadays the business partners are using what that is third party service provider called VAN, value added network. And this value network will manage the data communication networks for businesses that exchange electronic data with other businesses. So what is the use of this VAN network means? So this VAN network is a third party service provider, just like our internet service provider. And this will provide communication between two different companies to exchange their EDI documents. So without this VAN, no EDI document will be transmitted from one company to another company. So this a value added network is a simple and a secured private network, so that act as an intermediary between business partners sharing standard data. So in order to share standard data between the companies, so the companies needs what a secured connection or a secured channel, and the secure channel will be provided with the help of what this communication network. Okay. And see here, this we can represent in the form of what diagram also, EDI VAN. See here, your supplier and your customer. And this is supplier VAN and this is a customer's VAN. So VAN means what? The private, their own private secured connection. So this private VAN will act as an intermediary between what supplier and customer. And whatever the documents are created by the supplier, those documents will be get converted into EDI documents. And those EDI documents will be transmitted to the customer through this VAN only. Without VAN, there is no exchanging of EDI documents between the supplier and customer, or between the two companies, or between the two wholesaler, between the two retailer, or any person, right? Yeah, so that is the use of right VAN. So how the customer knows and how the supplier and how the receiver knows they are able to get what EDI documents. So for this I will give one example, real-time example. So the Gmail service. So Gmail service will act as a what VAN network. Gmail service will use what VAN at the back. The Gmail company will use what a VAN network for sending and receiving the mails. So whenever you open your email account, in the inbox it shows whatever the mails you got, right? And in sent box it shows whatever the mails you sent to other people. That means what? That is called what? Mailbox. So in the similar way, this van also provide mailbox to the supplier and receiver. And whenever the supplier is sending any EDI documents, that will be saved in mailbox of customer. And also the van will intimate, so you got the mail or you got some so-and-so document from the so-and-so company to the receiver, it will intimate. So with that intimation, the customer or receiver knows he got some document from so-and-so company. And in similar way, receiver also can send some documents to supplier. And the supplier also knows what are the documents are transmitted from the receiver. So that will be known with the help of what supplier's van mailbox. That means what here, van will act as a intermediate and it is also called what a mailbox. So in this mailbox, it shows what are the documents are received and what are the documents are transmitted between the supplier and customer. And it also intimate the message to customer or to the receiver or to the supplier or to any other company. So and so mail you got like that, right? So this is about what EDI van. And see here, I said that how the order, how the any documents here, I take what a normal document is what a purchase order, which is created by one company. So this about, this part shows what purchase order. And this we can create what in MS Word or Excel, right? And what are the purchase order is created. So this is called what unstructured data. And this cannot be transmitted over the network to other company due to some security reasons, right? Why? Because this is not having any structured format, right? Why? Because different companies will use what different format for creating the thing. But here, in order to exchange the documents between the companies, they need some standard format. So that's why here, see, the left hand side, bottom side, left hand side, this is what ANSI EDI purchase order. That means what this purchase order is convert into EDI purchase order by using ANSI, that is standard. And if you see right hand side, see, same purchase order is converted into EDI document with the help of what EDI fact standard protocol. So here I under EDI standards of PPT, I shown two examples of EDI standards. One is what ANSI EDI and the second one is EDI fact. So any company can use what any one of the standard protocol for converting the normal document into standard document. See, this is called what a standard EDI document. And this is also called what a standard EDI documents, which is converted with the help of the EDI fact. So these documents will be get transmitted to the other business partners with the help of what a van network, right? So this is a real time example I'm showing here, right? And this we cannot understand, right? And how the other company of receiving this order, which is convert into some format, standard format, how they can take printouts and how they can see the original message means what they will use, but their own EDI software. Again, that EDI software will convert this standard format into the normal format. And after converting standard documents into normal documents, they can take what printouts for any other office purpose, any other purpose, right? So this is vice versa, right? Right. So this is about today's session. Right. So thank you all. So stay home, stay safe. Let's stop COVID-19. So till March 3rd, we have lockdown. Right. So don't go out without any unnecessary reasons. So wash your hands occasionally with soap. Right. So please maintain social distancing if you go outside.